Oh boy, what a day. We've all been waiting for this for a long time. First, I want to thank Deirdre for her tremendous leadership and partnership as the first CEO of NatCast. Deirdre, you've already done a great job starting to implement our vision from the CHIPS and Science Law. And thanks to everyone here at this historic moment for the Capital Region, for upstate New York, and for the whole country. Today is the dawn of a new day for Albany, upstate New York, and America. I'm proud to announce that America's first ever National Semiconductor Technology Center has officially opened here at Albany NanoTech. We didn't want it in any other place. It's a day I have long dreamed of. As Deirdre mentioned, I created the NSTC program as I wrote the CHIPS and Science bill myself and Senator Young, Republican. It was bipartisan, originated the bill in the Senate, and got it through in a bipartisan way, as it should be done. And my dream, when I wrote CHIPS and Science and wrote the NSTC program into the bill, was that it come right here to Albany NanoTech. And so it has. Today, Albany becomes the next frontier of scientific discovery throughout the world, throughout America, but also throughout the world. The launch pad for breakthroughs that today's engineers could not even fathom. The place where advancements once thought to be possible only in science fiction, are here today. This is the start of the next chapter for American semiconductor leadership, and we're all so proud it's happening right here in the Capital Region. Amazing. The premier research center for the next generation of semiconductors is not in San Francisco, is not in New York City, is not in Boston, is not in Austin, it's in Albany. I feel so good about that. A facility like this has never been done before. It's a revolutionary new effort for the federal government. And what it does is it brings together the nation's top scientists, universities, and companies all under one roof with the most advanced machinery in the world for chip making. When we cut this ribbon, it'll sound like a sonic boom that echoes from one end of the country and the world to the other. Countries are now looking here at the Capital Region as the new epicenter for innovation, not just for America, but for the world. We're planting a flag, sending a message loud and clear that the future of chips will not be discovered overseas. The world's most advanced chips will not be made in China. They will be made in America right here in the Capital Region. Chips are, we all know how critical chips are to our daily lives. They power everything from cell phones to computers. I like to tell people when you get a flat tire in the old days, you just hear clunk, 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 and have to get out of your car. Now it's on your dashboard. Why? It's on your dashboard even when the air is low. Because of chips. It's unbelievable what they have done to change our everyday way of life. And our new foundation and our new frontier, artificial intelligence, is chips are vital for that. Wouldn't have happened without the advancement in semiconductor chips. And we all know how rapidly that's changing our world, and we know how important, with AI being so important, that the top center for research in the world be right here. In upstate New York, we always lamented that too many manufacturing jobs went overseas, especially to China. I've seen the pain of parents at airports in Albany or Syracuse or Rochester or Utica or Buffalo or other upstate cities waving goodbye to their kids who wanted to stay here in upstate New York. They loved the life, but there were no jobs. And we all lamented that. and a cloud was cast over us. But now we have turned the corner. We have turned the corner. NSTC is that turning point, a once-in-a-generation shot to reverse that trend. This is the place to make sure the future is made in America and in upstate New York. And our dream, my dream, of making the corridor, the I-90 corridor, the semiconductor center of America, is coming to reality. In a few years, one quarter of all the advanced chips made in America will be done within 4 or 5 mile stretch from Buffalo to Rochester to Syracuse to Utica here to the Capital Region. And the research for that, and one of the magnets for that, is NSTC right here in Albany. It comes with a lot of investment. We got the largest investment in the CHIPS grants, $825 million in CHIPS research from the federal government. But what does that mean? $825 million is a lot of money, but it has to mean something real to people. It means companies from across the country will send workers here to get trained, and scientists across the world will come to New York to do research. It leads to my favorite four-letter word, jobs, J-O-B-S. And it's an enormous opportunity for new, good-paying jobs, not jobs when you take them, you know, hey, I may be fired or the company may close in 5 years, but jobs with an amazing future. It's incredible. The spillover effect is huge because it means more companies want to locate here in upstate New York. They want to be close to the lab to do research. The economic impact of having America's federal headquarters for chip development will be felt everywhere, from downtown Albany to I-90, to the I-90 across the state and down in New York City as well. We've already seen historic investment from my CHIPS law. Micron's historic $100 billion investment in Syracuse. Global Foundries, Tom is here, $13 billion investment just up the Northway in Saratoga County. Edwards Vacuum, a British company, adding over 600 jobs in Genesee County between Buffalo and Rochester. All IBM expanding their R&D here at Albany NanoTech, and so much more. Wolfspeed in Utica, so many other companies across the map of New York and especially upstate New York. And this is the facility where all these companies can perfect their technology, where they can train workers, hire students who learn from the best in the world, a win-win that will help new factories get up and running quickly. It also means that the most advanced machinery in the world, it's already here, but will continue to be located right here in Albany and in upstate New York. Albany Nano will be home to the only public high NA extreme ultraviolet lithography center in all of North America. One of only two such public facilities in the whole world, and ours is better than the one over in Europe. Hear that? These machines are the size of a school bus. They weigh over 200 tons. They use light to make microchips thinner than even a human hair. Any company that wants to be on the cutting edge of technology, and cutting edge of microchip technology in particular, needs to use one. But so few have access to them because how expensive they are. But they will have access here. And one of the beauties of Albany Nano is that it was invited everybody in. Some of the other companies, cities, wanted to make this research center just available to them. Intel was one of our big competitors, but the results would have only gone to Intel. But the beauty of this, of how the founders, Anderson and so many others, created this, is that we let everyone in. Companies not just from America, but from around the world, universities from across the country. All kinds of different people would benefit, and that is so, so important. So, our future begins today. This is ground zero for building America's technology future. Now, before I end, I want to acknowledge some partners who made this possible. I am blessed with a great staff. And I can just point to two people in particular, one of whom you all know, Steve Mann, my great representative. He's been with me since I started in the Senate in 1999. He's floating around modestly over there. And many of you worked with John Cardinal, brilliant. He was once, here's a little secret, when he was 17, he was mayor for a day of Ogdensburg, New York, where he comes from. But he pushed this through so well. So I want to give my staff amazing credit. None of this could have happened without their diligence, without their hard work. And there are so many others. The person who was going to speak after me is someone who played an instrumental role. I worked with her. Whenever I said we needed help from the state to do this, that, or the other thing, she was right there. She understood it immediately. Is our great governor, Kathy Hochul. She has the best excuse for not being here today that anyone could have. I just spoke to her on the phone to congratulate her on the birth of a new grandchild in Virginia with her daughter. So that's why she's not here, but she's certainly with us in spirit. It was Governor Hochul's dream and my dream to make New York a national model for the federal government and the state government working hand in hand to bring manufacturing from overseas. The New York Creates team was amazing. As I said, their vision of bringing everybody together and being so open and not being sort of, you know, it's just us, just helped make this, helped us win all the money and getting the center. So I want to thank Dave Anderson. Where'd he go? He was in a nice blue suit. There he is. Dave Anderson, Paul Kelly, and the rest of the New York Creates team, whose leadership built up this facility into the globally recognized place it's become. Their dedication, along with the work of Hope Knight and Kevin Yunus at ESDC, helped land the NSTC. I want to thank one of my partners in the House. When we passed it in the Senate, there was resistance from some of the people in the House, even the heads of some of the committees. But Paul and others worked real hard to convince people it was the right thing to do, and then it passed the House. And, of course, if it didn't pass the House, we wouldn't be here today. I want to thank our industry partners that made Albany NanoTech a global leader, from IBM, Global Foundries, Micron, Wolfspeed, ASML, Applied Materials, Tokyo Electronics, Electron, and so much more. And again, I can tell you, when I was trying to lure Micron to Syracuse, one of the best selling points was that we were going to get the NSTC here. They wanted to be near the Center for Research. That's also true of Wolfspeed. Tom had the good sense to locate here in the capital region before all this, but it's going to help him grow and expand. It worked out for so many others. And I want to give thanks to our university leaders. Special thank you to SUNY, to RPI, Syracuse University, and so many others that helped Cornell, that helped position upstate New York to lead in R&D, chip R&D, including the highly specialized work here at Albany Nano. It was a team effort, and so I'm proud of this whole team. I'm proud of how we all came together. I'm proud of how petty rivalries didn't get in the way here like they have in so many other places, because we all had one goal, to make Albany the center of NSTC, and today that is happening. Folks, for the Capital Region, for semiconductor chip research, the best is yet to come because of what we're doing today. Thank you. God bless you all.